like about
Cascadia.
Three things I like about. Three things I like about
Cascadia.
Three things I like about.
You know what that jingle means. I am going to talk to you about the three things I like about Cascadia. I am excited to share this with you because I backed this on Kickstarter and received my copy. I appreciate this game as a straight, light, entry-level game. And I'll tell you why in those three things that I like about, which leads me to my first thing. I really like how straightforward and easy to learn this game is. Here's how it works. Now, depending on how many players you have, you're going to take out a certain number of terrain tiles, but you will match a terrain tile by flipping over four with a disc of an animal underneath it. So you draw four terrain, lay them out, then you draw four animals, lay them out underneath, just one by one. So on a player's turn, they are simply going to take one combination of a terrain tile with an animal disc. That's it. They add it to their player area by simply placing the tile next to any other existing terrain tile. They then take their animal disc and they place it on the one they just took, or an adjacent terrain tile to the one they just placed. And you only place animals on tiles that have their picture depicted, and you want to make large areas of terrains to count at the end, and you want to create certain configurations of animals. Now, in the very beginning of the game, you're probably going to play with the A deck. It's kind of like the basic introductory starter deck, and these are cards that give you particular goals for all the animals. And they are publicly displayed. Everyone knows exactly what configurations you want your bears to be in, or your salmon, or, you know, something like that. So they have, you know, lines or patterns of some kind. And at the end of the game, you're going to score up your animals, you're going to score up your terrain types, and you're going to count those little pine cones. Those are going to be things that let you kind of manipulate the game in a particular way. The game is super straightforward, easy to learn, and quite honestly, easy to play. The second thing I like about Cascadia is the quality of production and the artwork. I think this game feels nice, it looks nice, and it plays well. There are really great goal cards, and the iconography is so clear. The breakdown is super easy to understand. There's the explanation in the book, so if you want to look in the rule book, you can check those out. But everything is just super easy to learn. It's just intuitive. They've done a great job with the graphic design and the artwork. I think it looks really nice. It's pleasing to the eye. The cardboard pine cones are nice quality. The tiles feel really good. And I like the colors on the discs. I think this game is quality. It feels good. It's made well. And I think it's made to last. And that leads me into the third thing I like about Cascadia. This game is going to be something that you play over and over again, and it really invites multiple plays. There are four sets of goal cards, and that's the goals that you want for each of those particular animal types. There's an A, B, C, and D deck. You can also mix and match. So you want an A bear and you want a D salmon. Great, go for it. So there are the goal cards that change up how you're piecing together your tiles and how you're placing your animals out onto your personal player area. There's also a solo play, which is cool. You could play by yourself. There's also a Cascadia Achievements track in the rulebook that kind of gives you long-term goals. So over the course of many games, you will essentially check off all of these different achievements, kind of like you're playing a video game and you want to get all those achievements, you know, bronze, gold, silver star, like how well you did something. But they also have these thresholds for doing particular achievements and things in the game, which kind of makes it this fun campaign, so to speak, inside Cascadia. Okay, so on to a couple of the things. There's actually two, and I will tell you they're pretty minor things that I don't like about Cascadia. The first thing is the tiebreaker. So the tiebreaker is pine cones. Now, you get pine cones for taking a tile and then placing an animal on a single habitat zone, which means only that animal can go in that habitat, which is kind of, it's particularly challenging, especially if you're not getting the draws you need for animals and tiles. Now you get a pine cone for that, and you can use pine cones to take two different tile. You take a tile in one, but you don't take the animal that matches the tile. You take an animal from a different zone. That's how you use a pine cone on your turn, to kind of give flexibility and give you an opportunity to not be totally tied down. So pine cones are great to be used in the game. I think they're great for in the game because sometimes you get lucky and sometimes you don't. Well, pine cones let you overcome the unluck of the draw from the bag. And that's something that I appreciate as a gamer. Well, when you get to the end of the game and you tie, like I did, I use more pine cones because I need more help. My husband doesn't need the help. He's super lucky. I lost the tiebreaker because I didn't have as many pine cones. And they count as victory points at the end of the game. They shouldn't count again as a tiebreaker because you already counted them as a victory point. So I think there should be a different tiebreaker, or you should just say everyone rejoices in their shared victory, which I know everyone usually hates in a game, but Cascadia is so simple that to have a tiebreaker, something that you already count as victory points and is something that you want to use because it encourages players to be more strategic and to kind of overcome bad luck, I was like, nah, I didn't like it. So I won't be playing with the tiebreaker of the pine cones in Cascadia. It will just be a rejoiced shared victory in my house. The second thing I don't necessarily like as much about Cascadia is I thought this game was going to be a little bit more educationally focused. I thought I was going to learn more about Cascadia, about the Pacific Northwest. I got it because I live in the Pacific Northwest inland, and I really was like, ooh, I'm going to learn about the terrain, I'm going to learn about the animals. No, not really. When you play the game, you could like not learn anything. The actual like information is on a page in the rule book in the back that like tells you about the animals and about the terrain. And so you kind of had to just sit down and read. And so you don't learn through playing. And so that's kind of my second critique of the game is I thought I would be actively learning more. Maybe there should just be more visible information available. So what I've done is I've shifted my focus to light entry-level game that is very replayable because of the interchangeable gold cards and because there's a solo play, because there's an achievements page. Cascadia has a lot to offer. Try it. Try Cascadia. Play the game if you can get your hands on it. I think you'll really enjoy how easy it is to get into the game and how fun it is and how balanced it is. Again, I told you, my husband and I, we tied. And we had very different groupings of terrain. We had very different scoring on our animals, and we came out exactly the same. So we took very different approaches, different strategies, and it was still super fun. So I think the game is balanced. I think new gamers will love this. I think young gamers and families will really like Cascadia. So I do hope you enjoy Cascadia and those three things I like about it. I will catch you next time.
Three things I like about
Cascadia.
Three things I like about
Cascadia.
Three things, three things, three things.
Cascadia.